For start, create 2D or 3D project. We gonna use a free asset for our purpose. Pixel art top down basic. First, let's add pixel art top down to our project. Then we need two more assets, one of which is a universal render pipeline or high definition render pipeline. There is no difference, choose whatever you want. Then we need to add visual effect graph to our project. Now, create a pipeline asset and set it to graphic and quality in the project setting. Go to project. Right click. Create. Visual effects, and create the visual effect graph. Call it fog, and drag it to scene. Now we can see the visual effect is created but not showing, because of the order and layer of these sprites. I prepare the code which will fix the problem. You can follow my previous video to learn more about it, and download it from there. Now let's go to the VFX graph. We need to control the fog amount. So let's create a new property, it's float and named fog amount. We use that to control the spawn rate of particles. And set the default value to 300, then connect that to the spawn system rate. Increase the capacity to 15k so we can hold the 15k active particles in the scene. Now we need to set parameters to control the wind direction, so it will set vector 3 to control the minimum and maximum. Then we can use those to control velocity random. Scroll down and change the main texture to the default particle texture. You can use any other texture if you want. Let's adjust the lifetime to 10 because the fog particle should stay for a long time on the screen. Now particles are spawning from one point, but we need them to spawn within the box, so let's create a new node called setPositionABox, inside the initialize particle section. And we can control the box location and size to decide where the particle should respawn, but if the box adjustment didn't work for you, just close the visual effect graph and open it again. Now we need to control the size of each particle in the fog visual graph. So let's create a new node, set size random, and we will randomize the value between two values. Here in the update particle, we need to add collide with sphere. We will have a sphere area that is clear from fog. This can be the player location, so it clears the fog around him. We can increase the bounce to 0.3, which means when a particle hit this collider it will go back a bit. Also we can increase the lifetime loss to 1, that means the particle which hits this collider will die immediately. Additionally, to make this fog feels more realistic, we need to make particles go around the sphere. To do this, we need a new node called conform to sphere. This will try to attract the particles to where that sphere is. Let's change the values to 0.1 or 0.2. I added the wrong node here, it should be set size random. Also, delete the set size over lifetime. Now we need to control the fog transparency. Let's go the set color over lifetime and change the color mode to alpha. Then we will add a new gradient property, we can change how it starts and how it ends with less alpha. For controlling the fog color, let's create a new node in the output section called set color random. So we will have two colors, the base color and secondary color. Fog is completed. You can make it better by changing and adding the new properties, but it's enough for now. We want to add script to can control the position of collide with sphere. By putting the sphere on the player, we can have a cool effect. For that we need a vector 3 property, set it to the center of sphere, then save the visual effect and close it. You can add a new script. Or change the particular script you already have. I'm going to change the player script, which is called top-down character controller. Let's add the VFX namespace. Then create a new object as visual effect. And for the last, just put the position of the player to the property we created. That works great, but there is a tiny problem with the bounds of the visual effect. By changing the bounds, this will never happen.